As EVs become more popular, a use has to be found for old gas cars. We can't just send them all to landfills. The solution is converting old gas vehicles into electrics. For years, weirdo hobbyists have been converting old vehicles, especially old classic muscle cars, since they have manual transmissions and few electronics. A couple weeks ago, a friend of mine came over for a fire circle. He mentioned he had his eye on an old diesel car, which he wanted to convert to biodiesel, which is another way of saying restaurant grease. So you can make a diesel engine work on leftover McDonald's fry grease. It's carbon neutral-ish, and the fuel is free, but the downside is you have to clean it constantly, and the car smells like french fries. So I said, you know, your other option is to get an old manual transmission classic car and turn it into an electric. The next day, he sends me a picture of a mid-engine rear-wheel drive JDM car, which he wants to convert into an EV. He says, do you want to go halfway on this? Tells me the price. I say no. The next day, he shows up at my house in the car anyway. So what had been an offhand comment at a fire circle became an imminent plan to make an electric vehicle out of a classic vehicle.
And here she is. Oh, what a little nightmare.
1994 Honda Acty.
It is literally from Japan. It's not like it was imported to America to be sold. Like, it's been driven in Japan.
A 1994 Honda Acty is actually ideal for converting into an EV. It has a light frame, meant to be pushed by a wimpy motorcycle motor. It's got space for a battery. It uses rear-wheel drive, right under the heavy batteries. Being an old vehicle, it has very few components that would draw electricity away from the motor. It has manual transmission, manual windows, manual steering, and even manual airbags. It turns heads wherever it goes. Imagine the attention it would draw at a climate protest. Stick an amp in the back, park it, and climb up there with your signs. Hell, you could even turn it into a parade float. But we're sticking with our plan to make it into an EV.
This is Dave, he's the proud owner. There's nothing in front of us. There's literally the car is just, there's no car there.
It's smaller than you would think.
I've never owned a pickup, so I don't even think about like what do you use a pickup for?
You know, I still don't think you own a pickup.
It says truck on the license plate.
It would be easier to convert this to a Fred Flintstone. Just take the bottom out and run.
Don't mind my hat hair. It's from having the window open so that people could shout at us.
What the fuck you guys driving?
Yeah, that was...
Which I guess is a natural reaction.
There's no airbags in this, and there's nothing in front of us, and we're literally ahead of the wheels.
Here we go.
All right, here we go.
Oh, third gear. Oh, 0 to 60 in 100 years.
It feels like we are going like light speed right now because it just feels incredibly unsafe.
This is a manual car, which is actually good. You can see we're fucking around with the clutch here. I don't know why I was saying we. I'm not driving this thing. But it is
it's right-hand,
right-hand drive, because it's a Japanese vehicle. So
wrong-hand drive.
All of the, everything is on the opposite side. So anytime he reaches for the turn signal, he turns the windshield wipers on. We've got our ashtray here, and this is, what did we say?
50 yen.
50 yeah. yen? So you can use that on the highway. We've got an AM radio, and the speaker placement is optimal for surround sound. You know, really pumps it right into your knee.
Think about that. That's the bass line. Perfect tunes for rolling around Tokyo.
We've got. That guy has left the same engine as we do.
We should try to do a 0-60 in this, though, to see how long it takes.
What are we doing right now?
I think we're going to Dairy Queen, right?
Oh, I meant...
So 60 would be about 95 kilometers an hour.
But yeah, those are kilometers an hour. And after 4 gallons, you can see we're at full tank. And there's, like, really no bells and whistles here. Like, this is all manual. Which is actually good. You even got manual windows. And all of that means that this thing, when we convert it to electric,
yeah, there's not a lot of extra work that we don't want to do.
Yeah, the car is not going to spend a lot. Oh, I've got to order because I'm on the left-hand
okay.
side.
It's okay. In Shenzhen, they have like special toll lanes for the cars from Hong Kong because they're right-hand drive, but the cars in mainland China are left-hand drive. So they have this little like net on a stick that they shove into your car from the other side.
I will be right with you.
Okay, thanks.
Join us next time as we try to upgrade its AM radio into a modern sound system.